called the Hudson River lesson. We'll stick with our river themes and go with the flow. The Hudson River starts in the Adirondack Mountains in New York State, flows down through New York, the George Washington Bridge, Holland Tunnel, and the Lincoln Tunnels, cross the river to go into New Jersey, and then the river flows into the Atlantic Ocean. So today's lesson will be called the Hudson River. Just a reminder, let's go back a little bit, and safety, masks on over our noses, social distance, at least 6 feet from each other as we are in the streets and in the supermarkets. Wash our hands before, after we do things, after we touch things, wash our hands. So just a reminder for our safety. Also, remote learning. Everybody is going to get these lessons online. Go to your Google Classrooms on Monday. Mr. Boccia puts up the lessons only on Monday. You will see exercises for every day of the week. There will be a fun family calendar to do something every day of the month. And then Mr. Boccia is going to put one or two questions on every week on a Google form or something different. We'll continue with that. And those questions have to be answered by Friday. And then I can check the works on Friday or over the weekend. So let's continue. We have remote learning. And let's discuss some of our feelings. I'm just going to check my notes. And sometimes the thoughts we have and our feelings can influence our behavior. So some people might be thinking about the coronavirus, but I'm going to tell you something different. Sometimes people are afraid of snakes, and they get so scared that they either freeze, they can't move, or maybe they just go running away and not think. So we have to think how our actions could affect us. So if I'm with, say, Mr. Boccia likes snakes, by the way, but if I'm scared of snakes, and my thoughts are only worried about the snakes, I could hurt myself or someone around me. So I need to reduce this stress. I want to think about what I can do to help me not be so scared or anxious, because I could get hurt. So that's why Mr. Boccia talks about the breathing. To reduce stress, breathe slowly, right? In our nose for 5 seconds. Out our mouth, 5 seconds. It can slow things down, calms my body, helps me think clearly, and then I can make a better decision. So if the snakes are there, I can maybe think of a choice that would help me. Maybe you can think of a different thought, a happy thought that's going to calm your body. That might also help. So those are just some things that you could do to help reduce your stress. So that's one thing. So now we're going to go into just some stretching, because I like to do my stretching again. I stretch my body to wake it up, because if Mr. Boccia runs real fast, I could hurt my body. So I like to shake down low, shake up high, shake down low. I shake out below. I look up, I look down, I look up, I look down. Let's go to this side, this side, this side, this side. I like to turn my head. Turn your head. Turn your head. Turn your head. Roll your shoulders. Roll them the other way. Make a small circle. Small circles the other way. Let's make a nice big circle. Nice and easy, back the other way. And then I just open my arms a little bit. And get my body moving, side to side. Around. Remember, we can do tight pose, hands are up straight, next to my ears, palms face, feet closer together. Keep your arms straight, you go to one side as far as you can. You can go up, back to the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Try to open the 6, and then we go down to the ground. Then we go the other way, up, down to the ground. Let's touch the ground, keep my legs straight. Back up, around my hips. Then we go this way. And I like to go side to side, maybe bend my knees a little bit. Wiggle up and down. And let's go this way. Stretch a little bit more. Hold one side. Hold the other side. Back up. Now I'm going to stretch my calf muscle, so I'm going to make my back leg really straight. My toes point in one direction. I bend my front leg, body straight, and I'm just going to hold like this. And switch legs. Lower body. And then I like to do a little wiggle from my ankle. A little wiggle, a little wobble, a little wiggle, a little wobble, a little wiggle, a little wobble. Let's do our lunge hold yoga pose. So again, my body is straight. I take a step with my foot. Bend my knees, not past my toe. Go on my tippy toes in the back. I can go down, body straight, look forward, and we hold for 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Back up. Other leg. Step. Bend. Tippy toes down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Back up. Breathe a little bit. My next yoga pose will be called airplane. I'll show it 2 ways. The first way, I'm going to go sideways. And I'm just going to take a step. I bend my knee. I like to over my toe. Arms can go out and my palms go face the ground. I lean forward, go on my tippy toe and my back foot. I pick this up. Make my legs straight, and then we hold. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we can go down and take a step back. Now I'll do it facing you, and I'll do my other leg. I take a step. I bend. I can put my tippy toes, my back foot, lean forward. Arms go out. Keep up. And as I pick my foot up, make my legs straight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we go down. Take a breath. That's our airplane pose for yoga. Check my notes for 1 second. And we'll do some exercises. So just to go over, we did jumping jacks last week. Out and up, down and in. Out and up, down and in. Let's do 5 together. Number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can do that at home, and we'll explain the choice board in a minute. Leg lunges, look next. So I'm gonna do this sideways. I step forward, down, back. Switch legs, down and back. Switch legs, back. Switch legs, back. I like using my arms as an extra exercise. Now we do reverse lunges. Take a step backwards. Go straight down and then bring this foot back to the front. Take a step back. Go down, this leg, up to the front. Back, down, up, and back, and down, up. We'll do our leg lunges, forward, and back. Now, 2 new ones that you may know, toe touches. These we go all the way down. I spread my feet apart, underneath my shoulders. I like to put my hands on my hips. I cross my body over so it's opposites. And my hand goes all the way to my tongue. Up straight. Body needs to be straight. Go to the other side. Up straight. Down. Up. Down. Up. Right. Cross my body. Down. Back up. Cross. Down. Up. Toe touches. You can do about 10 of those. My next exercise is going to be called leg extensions. Leg extensions for my quadricep muscle, part of my leg. Quadriceps, part of my thighs, we use it for running, walking, jumping, squatting. The exercises, we know how to do leg lunges. I'm going to show you leg extensions. Leg squats are just sitting in a chair. That's on the choice board. I'm going to do leg extensions two ways. Standing and sitting. So first I'm going to get the chair for the sitting. You can sit in a chair at home. And I just sit, and all I mean is picking my foot up, keeping my leg still. You can feel your thigh muscle working. I need six on this side, four, five, six. Then you need to do the same on the other side. One, two, three, four. I try to keep my toes pointed up. Five, six. Leg extensions. That's for sitting, and that's the best way. You may need to try to do it standing. And I'm going to have to pick my foot up, pick my leg up, and I'm going to have to do it this way. Let's go sideways. One, two, three, four, five, six. It's harder that way because you're working more muscles. We would have to do it on both sides. Those are leg extensions. Now, Mr. Boccia gave you the choice boards to do the exercises. The jumping jacks, I gave you 12 different types of jumping jacks. You pick three of them each day. On here, it says you do each time you do a jumping jack, do it for 30 seconds. So if I'm going to do regular jumping jacks, I would do them for 30 seconds. See how many you get. Take a 1 minute break. Do that same jumping jack again for 30 seconds. Take a 1 minute break or a 30 second break. Then you have to do it again. That's what three sets mean. That means three different times. Then you would pick another jumping jack, and you would do that three different times, 30 seconds each time. So that's what the directions meant. Same thing when we do our quadricep exercises. There's 12 to choose. If you don't know how to do them, you click on it, and you'll see me doing it for you. Again, you do each of the exercises three different times, and each time you do it, you have to do it six times. I'm going to have to do six on this leg, six on this leg. That counts as one time. So remember, you have to do each one three times. I hope I explained it. Now, those are our exercises. Let's talk a little bit about rules to games. We all play different games with our friends, with ourselves. What would happen if there were no rules? You wouldn't know how to start. You wouldn't know whose turn it is. You wouldn't know how to score points. And you wouldn't know how to play. So rules are important. The Google form that I gave you tried to explain what would happen there were no rules. You wouldn't know who won the game. You wouldn't know what to do. And someone could get hurt. So rules are important. So I'm giving you the answers here for that Google form. So hopefully you listen and you answer the form. The other Google form talks about proper etiquette. Codes of behavior. Etiquette is manners in a game. What type of manners would you need in a game? How do you play the game with others so it's fair, good manners? Maybe take turns. Everyone gets a chance. Let others play in the game. If my team is winning by a lot, I don't want to tease the other team. That would be proper etiquette. So again, I'm giving you some of the answers to the other Google form. Lastly, I know I'm doing a lot of talking and I apologize, but these are just some things we do when we play games. Lastly, it's about setting goals. Goals in phys ed would be, how many times can you do a jumping jack in 30 seconds? I'm not going to do 30 seconds, I'll do it in 15 seconds. So, I'm going to go 1,000, 2,000, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And we'll say I did 10 in 15 seconds. I would want to do at least 10 more, 10 times when I do 15 seconds. I might say, you know, I want to try to get to 15. Or I might say, I was tired after 15 seconds. I want to be jumping jacks for 30 seconds. So you have to practice getting better. So setting goals means you're practicing to get better. I'm not going to be jumping jacks for 5 minutes. That's going to be way too much. I'm not ready for that. So I start small, and if I can do it, then I can go to the next step. Same thing when I do my leg exercises. I want to do leg squats, so I'm going to try to do, let's say, 5. Then I'm going to go down, 1, down, 2, down, 3, down, 4, down, 5. I did that. That felt pretty good. I think I can do 6 next time. But I need to do that 3 different times. So I would have to do that again 5 times. So let's try that. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That felt pretty good. I'm a little tired at the end of the 5th one. So we'll see. I'm going to try to do it again 5 times because I needed to do it 3 sets. So that was the 2nd time I did it. And I'm going to see how I feel after this last one. So I'm going to try to do 5 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So I feel pretty good. I think I can do 6 the next time. But I'm not going to go up to 10, because I don't know, that might be a lot. So I might go slowly. If it was very easy, maybe I'd try 8 next time. So you have to decide. If something's too easy, you might be able to do a lot more, but if it's just right, you keep it the same, and you go up slowly. I'm going to talk about goals more in the future. So with that, my friends, thank you once again, and I hope you get to see the video and do the activity.